Time now to go live to the trading desk. Victor Adair joins me. Now, Vic, come on. I'm going to start right with this. What the heck is the Kenny Rogers School of Risk Management?
Well, everybody remembers that song. I think it was one of his all-time big hits, The Gambler. You got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them, you know when to walk away, know when to run. And, of course, he does a much better job of singing it than I do. I tell you what, you know, Friday of the previous week, I had four positions on at the end of the week, and they were all what we would call in the green. In other words, I was ahead on all of them. But as this past week started, like I could see it Sunday afternoon and coming into Monday morning, the market was going against me on everything that I had on. I was short Canada, short New Zealand. I was basically short gold and WTI through the options market. So my job as a trader is to liquidate quickly positions when they're going against me. And that's the business of you got to know when to hold them and know when to fold them. I make money when I'm going in the same direction as the market, and I lose money, you know, when the market's going against me. So the thing to do is just to get out of the losers, keep the losers small, keep my head clear, maintain, protect my capital, but certainly be prepared to admit this ain't working. Let's head for the hills.
Are you sitting on the sidelines then? I mean, that's an important lesson. Like, I find way too many people think they have to deploy their capital on a momentary basis. They're actually not comfortable when they're not trading, and I find that a dangerous kind of approach, let's say.
I mean, I was out of the market early Monday morning and half the positions and early Tuesday morning of the other half, and as I did sit on the sidelines for a couple of days just because I didn't see anything I really wanted to do. And I do not do something just to keep busy. But then we got to Friday, and something, I guess this has been one of my main trading themes this year, is that I thought that the top we made in the American stock market in January was very important, and then the big break we had in early February, well, let's say, was a sign of, I think, more to come. So what I've been doing is anytime the market kind of bounces back, but runs out of steam, I've been shorting the market, and I've definitely made some money doing that. And then on Friday, we had the American market bounce back, make new highs for a month. Early Friday morning, there seemed to be a little enthusiasm over some of the bank share quarterly earnings reports that were out. But then the market kind of rolled over, and I just decided, okay, I'm going to get short here. I have a point if the market continues up higher in the next few days, weeks, whatever, where I'll get out. But I just think maybe the predisposition of the market is to trade lower. I think also, to be fair, that part of the weakness going into the close on Friday was people just thought, hey, I don't want to have exposure. I don't want to go up and buy something just ahead of the weekend. So now we've had the events of last night in Syria. There's all kinds of questions as to, you know, basically, who do you believe about what? And the main question is, what happens next? I could actually picture the market opening higher, going against me on Monday, on the sentiment that, okay, they launched the missiles, okay, and that's it, it's behind us. Things could have been worse, so, you know, we're a buyer. I don't know what's going to happen. I've kept my position set small.
Well, we'll be here to look at it, Vic. As I say, one of the things we started off the whole year with is expect this incredible volatility for at least 6 months. Boy, that certainly has come to fruition as we watch these rapid triple-digit rises, triple-digit falls, that kind of stuff. You know, lots of news behind it. But, man, it's a hair-raising kind of experience. I think it's great for traders, and we'll find out what you did next week.
Mike, that volatility you talk about is across the markets. I mean, crude oil, we were up about $6 on Friday's close from where we were last week. Stock market feels really on edge to me, and the currency markets are the ones that is just sort of going sideways, but feel as though, you know, the doors could come off. So, yeah, lots of volatility.
Great stuff. Live from the trading desk, Victor Adair.